I'm going to show you how to work with the drop down and the checkbox. If you see here, this is the drop down, and based on our this Excel, if our quantity is 2 in this Excel, then we have to select 2 from this application, from this drop down, then you will able to generate, calculate this order value. If you will directly type here, it will not work. Let's say if I'm putting here 12, and then if I am putting here 3, then this will not calculate the value here. For that, you have to select from here, and now you can see it is generating the order value. So here by default you can see in the checkbox that is unchecked, and if we are getting true in our Excel, it means that should be checked. It means we have to check this. If it is false, there's no need to check that. So let me take here few condition for false as well. False, now let me open Object Studio, and here you have seen we have taken type into product code and then unit price. Now the next one is quantity. So here to work with the drop down, you have to take navigate stage, because in this scenario we are not going to type any value here, we are going to select value from this. It means we are going to navigate this pop-up, open this one and then select anything. So we'll take navigate and then we'll write here select quantity, and then we'll select that drop down quantity in the element, we'll drag and drop, and then from the action you will see here we have select item. So to work with the drop down, you have to take this select item, and we have to pass that value. If you'll see here in the item text, click on this, and here we need to pass that item text that we need to select here. So item text will be order collection dot whatever value we'll get from our Excel. So this is quantity, so we'll put here quantity. Now press OK. Okay, now we have taken product code, unit price, select quantity, and then we have customer account. So we have already done that one, I believe. Let me check that. So this is the order customer account. Let me put that name, customer account, and we are passing from this one. Now in this priority order, this checkbox we need to check here. So first we have to take one decision. Let me zoom in decision, and then we'll check here priority if it is true. If priority true, if we are getting true here, then we'll check here order collection dot priority if equals to true. If we are getting this value, then what we need to do, if priority true, then we have to click on that checkbox. It means we have to check that. So to check that checkbox, we have to take navigate again. So to work with the drop down and checkbox, we have to take navigate stage. Check priority. Checkbox and take this priority checkbox in the elements, click on action, and then take this place, link this, now if you see here, if priority equal to true, then check the checkbox. If this is not true, then there is no need to check that, because by default we are getting unchecked here. So we'll take one anchor stage here and we'll take one anchor stage here. Connect this with this one. So this is no, select here and this. And after this checkbox, we need to click on submit as well. So we are missing one thing. Let me take one navigate stage so that we can click on submit button. So take submit button here in the element, select, press, click OK, and put the name. Click submit. And click OK. Now just link this here. We need to publish this one. And after going to the orders page, now you can see that. Reset this and save this. Now go to the process studio, and then here we are taking loop order and then action stage. We will take this Centrix data solution and then we'll take add new orders, and then here we need to pass orders collection. So order collection, currently we have this order collection in our get Excel Azure collection. We'll pass this one because we are going to pass this value from this to our Object Studio. Click OK, and then we can link this one. Here also we are missing one thing. Let's delete this, and after getting the collection here, we can again take one action so that we can close the instance. We can write close workbook or like close instance MS Excel VBO and take here close workbook. We can take the handle and workbook name and save data. No, we can write here false, do not save data. I don't want to save this time. Click OK. Link this. Now in the Object Studio, it will type all these things. It will click on submit. So we have designed our, you know, studio, that process in this way. Let me try that way. So put here the product code, unit price 12.1, and then let me put here the account number, this one. And then click on this one. This is true. Click submit. So once you click on submit, it will give us one reference number. So I will show you this reference number, how to take this reference number from here. Only this value, and then write this value back to the Excel. Now if you click OK, and then it is coming to the orders menu. It means again we have to put here one and then click go. So we have to change our process here. What we need to do, we have to, let me just do one thing, get collection, and then let me cut this loop here, take here loop here and take this, cut this order. And then take this loop here, take loop here also, and then we can take our, okay, so we'll take one by one data from here, And then you can see here we have to go to the new order. So it means put one and then click go. So we have to take this one, cut this one, go here, and in the loop we have to now go here and then add new orders, then this one, link this. Now let me explain this one. And let me cut this also so that we can take new, close Centrix app, and then we can paste here. So we can make small pages here, connect this page, close Centrix. Now link this here, and now you see here, as per this process, first launch and login, go to orders menu, it means click on this, go to orders menu, and then go to orders menu, and then get Excel as a collection. It means first it will read this Excel data, and then it will take the collection in the loop, then put here in the application 1 and then click go, and then add new orders, click submit. Okay, and after that you had seen that time, then when we put the data there, you know, in the order, let me take this one, if we are putting here product code and then unit price, let's say this one, we are selecting any amount, any value here, then anything here, now click submit. And after click submit, we have to click on this order confirmed also. So what we can do, we have to go to the Object Studio application modeler, and then we can take one element, delete this, click on this, take one element, and the name is order confirmed. So we'll take here order confirmed pop-up message box, right? So this is our main page. Click control, click left click, and order confirmed. Let me check what we are getting here. Order confirmed, true. Here we are getting 32770. We can uncheck this one. Now highlight this, and this is correct. Apply. So we can take one child here, this is for click on OK. Confirmed, OK, identify, and click on this one, OK, button this button. Take this parent window text, because we need to just click on OK where the parent window text is order confirmed, and highlight this, and you can see now click apply and click OK. Now if we'll go to the Object Studio, after clicking on this one, we have to click on OK button as well. So what we need to do, we have to, after clicking on submit button, we have to take one wait stage so that we can verify that, we can check that element exists or not. So we'll check here wait for order confirmed, and we'll take here order confirmed pop-up. If check exist equal to true, wait for 5 second, click OK. If this is available, then we need to take one navigate stage, and this is for click OK, it means confirm that. click OK. And this is for confirmed OK. Click press OK. Link this with this one. Link this one. Link this one. And link this with AND also. Okay, we have to go to this and then we have to link this with submit so that it can click on submit here. Save this and close this and then close this one. Go to the main page and now you'll see here. Let me do one thing. Let me take only 5 records so that I can show you. Let me zoom in and let me run up to this one, run to this next stage. Now we are on the new orders page. Let's do by this way. Click step into. Type this select quantity. Check the priority true or not. It is going to the so it shows priority is not true. We have to check that. In this one, our current value equal to true. So there is some issue here. We have to pass like this, true, true. Okay, so just close this, reset this, save this. So that was the error here. Close this, go to the main, refresh and reset and run this. Okay. So you have seen here, it is able to click on submit. And now you can see there was a problem because after clicking on OK on the order page, we are getting one error here. So we have to, you know, put some delay, add new orders. And after clicking OK button, we can take here static. Wait. And that is wait for 5 seconds or wait for 10 seconds. So what we need to do here, just put the name wait for 5 seconds. We are putting here 5. Click OK. Save here. Close this. Process Studio. Reset and refresh this. And now run this. And now this is done. So application closed. And you have seen here, it is showing completed. So we have successfully processed all the 4 records here. Now here you have seen that, you know, after clicking on submit on the add new orders page, we are getting one pop-up. That is the order confirmed page. So in this one we are getting one reference number. So now in the next video I will show you how to capture that reference number, only that number, and then write in the Excel file again in the specific column.